personally, I went to China to compare what I'd heard with what they actually practiced in China. I went because I was very curious by nature.
What had you heard?
Well, only what the our Chinese captors had told us, how great they were working toward socialism and the great strides that they were taking in bettering the life of the Chinese people, who for so many thousands of years had lived a life of oppression under various governments and was backward. And
well, why did you feel this sense of identification, of wanting to know about them, had you not been told by our own army?
No.
They'd never discussed the Chinese?
No.
They never told you what to expect? Were you to be captured?
Yes, they said we'd be killed.
Did you hear about the Soviet Russians and what they did in Hungary?
That was the main thing that definitely made me take the step to return to the United States.
And when you made up your mind to come back to the United States, did they stand in your way? Did they try to persuade you to stay?
No.
Can we be sure that you yourself have not been sent back here in some manner to work on behalf of the Red Chinese?
You wouldn't know for sure.
Do they believe in our freedoms?
No, to them it's much different. And we have an aggressive government that's always hunting for war. And,
do you believe that the United States should recognize Red China?
Personally, I think they should.
Why?
It's a very big thing. They have a very large land area. They have 650 million Chinese population. And it's like saying it's a big elephant in front of you and you say he's not there.
He becomes powerful enough to step on you. Do you expect that they will become powerful enough to step on us?
I have no doubt.